Make a statement, or if we just ask some questions?
Ask questions.
All right. How emotional did you get once the final realization hit you that, all right, I can't do this anymore?
I think for me, I kind of been living this for a while. Starting in January last year, I knew something was not quite right, and find a way to play through that season, but kind of mid-summer here when we hoped that it was going to get a little bit better, and it kind of wasn't. So obviously I went to see Dr. Kamisa here last week and got the final result, and nothing really had changed, so that's kind of when it kicked in.
What's that moment like for you?
Obviously it's it is emotional, you know. It's it's been, I don't know, 15 years here, and even though I knew that I was on my last couple of years, but I wish that I could play a little bit longer.
When you had that conversation with your wife, is she delighted because she's not seeing you go through everything you've gone through? What's it like in the house?
Well, I think it's also mixed emotions. You know, I think Detroit and Red Wings has been such a big part of her life for the last, you know, 15 years for me, 11 for her. So we've been spending all, basically, a grown-up life over here. We have an American son, so it is mixed. But she has seen me, too, going through what I've gone through. So, I think she's happy, too, that I don't have to do that. But in the same way, I think also she knows that I want to play, and so she probably wanted me to play, too.
Henrik, what are you proudest of when you look back on your career?
Wow. That's, I'm not sure. But I think that I didn't see myself last this long, probably. You know, when I got drafted back in, I don't know, 99 as a seventh-round pick, and been through that, all the good things and some low things during my career. But, you know, being in one organization for the whole time, being named the captain for this organization, I think that's obviously something special. So there's a lot of things. I think also you probably kick in a little bit soon, or later. When you look back to it, I think now it's just, it's kind of surreal, you know, standing here and talking about them done playing. But I've obviously been through a lot. Played with some great teammates. Had some great teams throughout the years, and in 08, winning the cup probably is the highlight. But also, I thought we had some great teams around that too. And in 09, I thought we, you know, we were close that year too. So, but I would say all the guys that I probably played with throughout the years, you know, that's you made some special bonds with a lot of players.
Towards the end of the season last year, the last few games of the season, were you kind of, did you kind of think that maybe it was going to be your last games, and you're kind of savoring the last moments at all?
A little bit. You know, I thought the last game, it was a pretty good chance that I would be the last one. So I think the people close to me knew that.
What are the chances of
turning for the worse, really? Like, right around mid-season or something?
Yeah, I think in January, that's probably when I stopped practicing. That's when it kind of went south. But nothing really new, though. It was kind of the same thing that's been going on, but it's just got worse.
What did you have to talk to any of your teammates about this?
Yeah, you know, I that had kind of been the tough part, too, for everyone. Most of the guys probably saw this coming, but obviously now when it's official, you know, I'm glad I'm up here, spend some time with them.
What's next for you? What are you going to do with all this time?
I don't know, you know. He'll be happy, but I don't know, you know. We'll see what happens here. Probably going to sit down with Kenny and Blash and see what's next.
Do you plan on staying in the U.S. or moving back to Sweden? Or
no, we're staying here. Lou started school here last week, so we're going to stick around.
You think you want to stay in hockey in some form, some way?
It's too early to say here. Yeah, you know what? Right now, I'm still, you know, I still feel like I'm playing, so it's hard to see what's the next step is.
Did you talk to, I don't know, guys like Steve or guys who, you know, had significant injuries and weighing quality of life long term versus wanting to play? Did you reach out to anybody who's been through a similar thing?
Well, when you talk to retired guys, there are not a lot of guys that walk away, you know, themselves, except Nick. So most of the guys, you know, have injuries, and that's kind of what's the reason why they have to stop playing. So you talk about that, but I think also I know too. I got to know my body pretty well the last couple of years, and I know when it's bad, and I don't have that many more solutions to do with my back, so it's time.
How difficult as it may be, are you at peace with this decision, of a sense of relief, or are you just greatly disappointed?
Both, you know. I'm happy with what I've accomplished. You know, it's but in the same way, I would love to play, you know, playoff hockey at LCA. You know, I would get that chance. You know, we have a really interesting group of guys here. You know, young guys and that we saw last few years been taking steps, and it would be fun to be with them a little bit longer. But I don't know. I'm just going to watch and support them.
Did 1,000 points factor into your decision? Getting to 1,000?
960 or what it is. You know, I'm pretty pleased with that too.
In your absence, obviously, is going to leave a leadership void on the team. Who do you see kind of stepping in, some of the guys that can help fill that?
You know, I think that the leadership group we have is strong. You know, the assistant captains, we have some, you know, some younger guys that's been here for a while, and I think that's it's always been that here. You know, one player has to see on the jersey, but we have a lot of leaders. So I'm not sure really what's going to happen this year, but we have guys that can take over. I don't know. You probably have to ask them, but I think Croner's been the one that's been closest to me. So I don't think he is that surprised that this happened.
What are you going to miss the most about playing for this organization?
Just playing in front of the fans. I think we have the greatest fans in the league. You know, everywhere we go, we have they're supporting us even in the rougher times. But so that's probably it. You know, just preparing for games and being, you know, playing hockey and then you're just gonna miss the guys. You know, miss that life that I basically been doing for the last 20 years.
And last season, the last couple of years, I mean, were there any games at all that you weren't feeling pain? I mean, how many nights did you come close to saying, I can't go tonight? I mean, just too much pain.
There was a few close calls, I think. In mornings, we probably thought I wouldn't come and play, but found a way to get out there and but all the way up till January, I felt pretty good. You know, like it's basically what I've been dealing with the last 2-3 years. So it's nothing really more than that. But it was after that when I couldn't really practice either. That's you can't just play games.
Ken said it's degenerative. Is your back going to get worse regardless of you not playing, or are you fairly confident your quality of life is? I mean, are you able to pick up your son?
You know what? Like, that's obviously, you know, if I, you know, keep doing the right things, hopefully I will feel pretty good. You know, it is me playing, you know, I think that's the, when you have nerves involved, you know, that's kind of shutting down some of your muscles and that kind of gets iffy sometimes when you're on ice. But walking around normal life, you know, I'm pretty decent.